Well, that oil spill in the Gulf isn't getting any better, and the people in Louisiana are rather upset about it. It may be a political problem, but as we've said before, I don't think we should blame politicians on account of BP screw-up. That's my feeling.
Well, the public doesn't think the government or the president has done a good job with the disaster. Here's Jennifer Wishon.
Although most Americans place the blame for the oil spill on British Petroleum, public opinion of President Obama's handling of the crisis has soured. A USA Today Gallup poll shows a majority of Americans, 53%, say the president is doing a poor job of handling the spill. And that includes critics from the president's own party.
Man, you got to get down here and take control of this. Put somebody in charge of this thing and get this thing moving. We're about to die down here.
Fishermen are desperately trying to help, some even volunteering to clean the waters that sustain their families.
There ain't nothing else we could do.
In his first press conference since last July, the president is expected to issue a six-month moratorium on new deepwater oil drilling while a presidential commission investigates the Gulf spill. He's also expected to announce that lease sales for drilling off the coast of Alaska will be delayed pending the commission's findings. Lease sales planned in the western Gulf and off the coast of Virginia will be canceled. President Obama heads to the Gulf Coast tomorrow to assess the damage for himself. Residents say they hope he'll listen to local leaders who want to implement their own plans to protect and clean up their precious marshlands. Jennifer Wishon, CBN News.
Didn't I tell you that would kill all, you know, deep water drilling?
Well, right now, how could it not?
Well, of course, who's going to let it happen? Yeah. I mean, can you imagine the guys in Florida and Virginia? You're going to ruin Virginia Beach. You're going to go out there and drill. I mean, it's a terrible thing, and it turns out that BP was in a hurry. You can't blame them. They were spending $500,000 a day on that rig, not to mention the drilling costs. It was a huge outlay, and they were in a hurry. Well, haste makes waste. But as much as I'd like to blame Obama, you just can't do it. He didn't have anything to do with it. But the American people are blaming the White House, like, you're the president, do something. Well, you want him to put on a wetsuit and dive 5,000 feet and put his hand in the plug like the little boy at the dike?
I don't know. Let me think about that.
Yeah. That's what you'd like to see. Well, I'm trying to be kind to the president. Lee Webb has the rest of our top stories from the CBN newsroom. Lee?
Pat, two Iranian Christians are free after months behind bars. Iranian police arrested Mariam and Marjeh more than a year ago for their Christian faith and activities. The women endured repeated interrogations and solitary confinement in a notorious Tehran prison. They refused to denounce their faith in Christ, even though it meant they could have gone free. But now they've been acquitted of all charges and have left Iran. Mariam says, I believe our arrest, imprisonment, and subsequent release were in the timing and plan of God, and it was all for His glory. Americans who grew up in the golden age of television are remembering legendary television host Art Linkletter. He passed away at the age of 97. He was best known for those funny, impromptu interviews with children, a segment he called Kids Say the Darndest Things. He hosted two of the longest-running shows in broadcast history, House Party and People Are Funny, and he said on the 700 Club that humor was one of the secrets to a long life.
You got to be able to laugh at life and at yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell older people when I talk to them at retirement communities, you don't have to be a comedian and tell jokes. Just laugh at, well, in the morning, if you want to have one good laugh during the day at your age, take off your nightgown and go stand in front of a mirror.
You can see that interview on CBNNews.com. Art Linkletter also wrote 28 books. He's survived by his wife, Lois, two daughters, seven grandchildren, and 15 great-grandchildren. And, Pat, I know it was a delight for you to interview him several years ago.
Art was a simply fabulous human being, a wonderful man, wonderful Christian, and a fellow who never lost his sense of humor. We're diminished by his passing, but he lived, 97 years old. And when he was here, he was in his 90s and still going strong. I mean, amazing. But laughter is good medicine. But we miss him. The world misses Art Linkletter. Lee?
President Obama is urging Congress to pass a $30 billion jobs package for small businesses. The money would be used to boost lending to small businesses planning to expand. It would also give relief to small community banks. The president is calling on Congress to cut taxes for U.S. companies hit hardest by the recession. Small businesses lost an estimated 2.4 million jobs during that time. A full House and Senate vote on the bill is expected soon. Pat?
Well, you know, folks, they're schizophrenic about this thing. They've got all kinds of regulations that hurt small business. It's as if they are attacking capital. The Congress has got another tax planned on people who had so-called carried interest. They're going after them, and they're going to penalize people who made money. There's no question about it. And so you say, well, we want to ease up and have more small business. Well, you're not going to have it the way you're proceeding, and throwing more money at it will not solve the problem. Whew. Small businesses, they're responsible for, I think, 80% of the new job creation in our country, those who have less than 200 employees.